What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, Dexter. New Blood, episode number 2. And it feels so good to have Dexter back. There were, like, moments in that episode, and I saw other people talking about this, that something just felt off. Mm-hmm. Something just felt weird about it.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden he gets to kill, and the inner dialogue shows up. You're like, oh, that's what
there
was missing.
He is.
The inner dialogue was missing through most of that episode. It was like kind of like, wait, what's going on? Something doesn't feel right. And this is the great part about watching a weekly show, because we could actually jump into comments. We could actually see what other people are talking about the show. I personally love the weekly release of shows. I think it's just so fantastic as a reaction channel. But it also allows us...
makes the schedule a lot easier.
Yeah, and it just makes it easier to not have to be so horrified of, like, looking at comments or any of that stuff. And, you know, one of the really obvious kind of things to take away from that first episode, Harrison's back. Did he kill his mama? Is Dexter going to teach him the ways Harry taught him the ways?
Stepmom, that's not his mom.
Right. I mean, at that point it was, yeah. But did he take Hannah out, and is that why he's on the road seeking Dexter? Hello, Dexter.
I don't know.
Morgan.
I mean, Hannah was fucking cray-cray herself.
I mean, she was.
So.
She liked to... What did she used to do? She used to just, like, drug people.
People.
Yeah.
All her poison ivy.
Yeah, seriously. So I think that's a really, really interesting idea, and it feels like... I kind of referenced an older season of Dexter where Harrison was born, ironically, and... things got a little too hectic. It felt like Dexter took on too much. And looking at that first episode, it almost kind of feels like him going back and seeing Harrison. Because he kind of, he shoot him off. He's like, I just have that kind of face. I don't know who you're talking about. I'm not Dexter Morgan.
Right.
But he went back to him and embraced him and brought him home. And I feel like it could potentially be, especially where he's living right now. This is such a small town.
I feel like this is going to be bad. How do you explain your previous life, dude?
Yeah, I feel like he's adding a little bit too much to his plate, which I think is going to be really interesting. Add to the fact that he killed this really obnoxious dude who feels really connected. And, like, he screamed at Dexter, like, my dad's going to, like...
rain down pain.
Like, bro, like, you're about to die. I don't know if that's necessarily the right choice of words there.
He's probably just going for it.
Yeah, he definitely went for it. But it feels like one of those things where his dad doesn't give a shit, or it's going to be the opposite, and dad's going to be really upset, and he's going to actually want to rain down hell on
pain
on whatever.
Okay. Anyway, no, I mean, what if the friends are just like, I don't know where he went. He took off with his gun. I don't know.
Yeah. They did show us some blood in the snow as they panned away at the end of the episode.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm wondering if that was the deer blood, because this asshole killed a really beautiful white deer. I'm wondering if that's deer blood or if that... what's the dude's name? What was his name?
Matt.
Yeah, whether that was his blood or the deer blood. I mean, Dexter's been 10 years out of the game, so it would kind of make sense that he would potentially leave something behind. But at the same time, he's still Dexter?
Yeah, dude, we got a whole season. I'm sure nothing is going to...
but that could be... that could potentially be the thing that starts the investigation.
Oh, that's true. But his girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, he's dating a cop, too. Just like Deb was prior. Which is very interesting. But, yeah, I mean, it would make sense for him to slip up a little bit just because of how long it's been since he's done this. And he doesn't necessarily have his routine. This was the first kill in 10 years, the first kill in this location, and it kind of felt like it came out of nowhere. He hadn't necessarily been preparing for it. He doesn't necessarily have the Miami Bay like he does now, but he's got all these little ice pockets that he could dump in the cold water. But... yeah, I
mean, unless you have piranhas, I don't know.
I don't know. There are a lot of questions after that first episode. I'm very curious to know how Harrison even found Dexter, first of all. But I feel like there's a lot of really good questions. I feel like there aren't, like, a ton of bad questions because, again, this is the first episode. We've got a whole season to play out. I think this is going to be good. This felt really good. It felt like Dexter to me. And it's going to be really interesting to kind of see how all this plays out. How does he go right straight? Like, how does he handle the situation with Harrison now? Does he teach him the way? Does he show him the code? Does he explain to him, like, hey, okay, this is who I was. This is who Dexter Morgan is. But now I'm Jim Lindsay. Like, that's not... You can't call me Dexter here. And you can't even be my son. Like, basically, right? Like, how is he going to handle and navigate this whole situation?
I don't know.
It's going to be crazy.
Yeah.
And, you know, Deb was in the first episode, and she essentially replaced Harry and has been protecting Dexter, it feels like. Unlike Harry was always kind of like, make sure you're following the code, make sure you're doing this, kind of like being his guide in terms of his kill. I feel like Deb was his guide to stay kind of clean from the kills.
That's true. I was going to say sober, but... You know,
I mean, I think
similar, I guess.
It definitely fits because Dexter had talked about, you know, his killing and the addiction and all of that. They've gone through that before in the past. But I'm wondering now that he's killed, is it still going to be Deb or does Harry come back?
That would be awesome.
I mean,
I would love to see Harry.
Like, I think that would be pretty crazy. I feel like that'd be a pretty symbolic switch to be like, okay, Deb was there kind of mentoring and helping him through this. And now that he's killed again, Harry is there to... You know, kind of take over and be like, all right, you're going to pass the code on just like I passed it to you, to Harrison. This is what you got to do because I've done this. I've been there kind of thing. And
or does he not tell Harrison about his dark passenger?
Yeah.
That would be a lot for a kid. Hey, by the way, I'm a murderer, serial killer.
I mean,
a little bit.
I'm not going to lie. Like, Harrison had those kind of creepy, there's not much there eyeballs.
Murdery eyes.
Like,
he had some stabby eyes.
Kind of looking at his eyes, it didn't look like there was a whole lot, like, there in terms of, like, emotion.
Rude.
Like, I mean, he felt emotion. He kind of was just like, if you don't fucking want me, just tell me. But besides that, it kind of just, I don't know. I think it would be really interesting for the story, especially considering how both of them were kind of experiencing things as a kid. Where, you know, Dexter was in the giant storage unit with his mom dead, covered in blood, and Dexter found Harrison with Rita in the bathtub and blood everywhere. So, like, obviously there's parallels there. And, yeah, that whole situation, I wouldn't be surprised if that's ultimately where we're going. But I'm very excited. I love that Dexter's back.
Yes.
I love that the voice is back. Can't wait to see where this goes. You have any other thoughts?
No.
Let's go.
What do I say? What can I possibly say to the son I abandoned?
It's gotta be so tough.
You got big. Happens. If you're cold, I can put some more wood on.
Fine.
You hungry? I could whip up some blueberry pancakes. Used to love those.
Yeah, I'm not five anymore. Maybe a sandwich.
One sandwich. Coming right up.
So when is he gonna reveal what his intentions are?
I don't know.
Figured he'd be a little more talkative.
Yeah, I mean, just...
Considering he's the one who's...
Seeking him out.
Yeah, we got second place at the Harvest Fest tournament last year.
Cool.
Dude, just...
Yeah, there's definitely something off with this kid, for sure. And it's more than just having my dad abandoned me issues, it feels like.
Oh, he's hungry.
So, you're not dead.
He's owed an explanation, but the only one is that his father is a monster.
I'm sure this is hard.
This? No. Growing up without a dad, that was hard. And opening up that letter, finding out you let me believe you were dead all those years. That was brutal.
Hannah showed you the letter.
No, I found it when she died.
Hannah died. Oh, shit. How?
Cancer.
Oh, shit.
Pancreatic.
I didn't know. When did she die?
3 years ago.
What happened to you? Where have you been?
A social worker put me on a plane from Buenos Aires to Miami. Bounced around a bunch of shitty foster homes. No one wants a teenager. Finally, I decided to find you. The return address got me that town in Oregon. I found where you worked. Also found that you left. That's when it got a little harder to track down Jim Lindsay. You know how many Jim Lindsays there are on the internet?
It's kind of the point.
And I found a shot of you on Instagram. Pictures don't lie. Some Fred guy and some bowling team bragging on you bowling a 300 right here in Iron Lake.
Wow.
So why all this Jim bullshit? What happened to Dexter Morgan?
He killed dozens of people, got your mother and your aunt killed too.
It's not who I am anymore. Dexter had to die.
What are you talking about? It's a long story.
Smart kid. He did a really, really good job of tracking him down. Yeah.
Stop.
You're not listening!
me from killing you again.
You selfish psycho. You are emotionally handicapped, crazy fuck. If by some goddamn miracle you don't end up killing him, you will sure as shit fuck him up.
Oh my god.
I'm not gonna fuck him up.
Dude, those Deb moments are intense. Storm of fuck. I really enjoy the way they're doing the episode titles so far. And they basically just gave us like a rapid fire shot of what the episode's gonna be like.
The fuck?
Is that who's responsible for all the missing girls in the area? Is that person just targeted a new girl to take? He sees the blood.
This is what happens when I give in to my dark passenger. But I can fix this. Teenagers sleep till noon, right?
Uh-oh.
Well, this is one storm of fuck.
There it is.
Nat Caldwell disappeared in the woods near here last night.
That's not good.
Your place is close to all the public hunting grounds, so I was hoping we could set up base camp for the search here.
Yeah, of course. Whatever you need.
Dude!
We probably got wasted and skipped
on. The searchers can stay warm. I'll get some coffee going. Breakfast, too, if you want.
For God's sake.
And my son is kind of just hanging out inside.
What's going on?
Jim, and this is...
Harrison, Jim's son.
Son.
Add that to the list of things I need to clean up.
Welcome to Iron Lake, Harrison. I'm Angela.
Smart kid went with the Jim line, good, but now he's gotta explain to the girlfriend.
Yeah, this is gonna be a little...
No teenage son?
Chaos.
Came here by yourself?
No big deal. Used to moving around a lot.
Your mother wasn't worried?
What are you two talking about? Mom, has she passed away?
I'm so sorry.
Of course, when that happened, I came up here to be with Jim.
So you're here for good. Well, you'll love Iron Lake.
Actually, we haven't really talked about it yet.
You should meet my daughter, Audrey. She's about your age.
Thanks for covering for me.
Didn't do it for you. Just didn't want a cop all up in my business.
Like father, like son.
Oh, boy.
That deer was killed on Seneca land. They're gonna find it soon. If I missed a blood trail to my own cabin, what else did I miss?
I was thinking Harrison and I can take that area near the woods. No, we want to help. The terrain gets rough. My RTV will get through it faster.
Okay, fine. You and your son can take it.
Oh no.
Fucking champagne.
You're kind of swerving a lot.
Just avoiding rocks.
Usually blood sets my teeth on edge. Now it's giving me whiplash.
So why here?
It's quiet, peaceful, no crime.
No temptations from the outside world.
No crime? You think this missing guy just, like, got lost out here?
Probably people get lost in these woods all the time.
How much do you think Harrison knows about Dexter's, like, past?
That deer was shot on Seneca land. It's against the law to kill them. We need to tell Angela. My phone won't work out here. Can you drive the RTV? Just follow the trail back and get them here as fast as you can. I'll make sure no one disturbs the scene.
Like, does he know that he was, like, a blood splatter analyst for...
Right? I need to know, like, what all he knows. I mean, like, especially since Hannah... he... I know, but, I mean, you search Google, you know, Dexter Morgan.
I'm sure He did a good enough job being able to find him. I'm sure he knows who and what he was, at least outside the murder stuff.
The mystery is, where did I screw up?
They always say killers return to the scene of their crime, but this is fucking ridiculous.
It's not fucking funny.
She's like antagonizing him. It's friggin' crazy.
Mystery solved.
You think Windexing that rock is gonna solve your fucking problem?
Yes, I do.
He has your brain. He's smart enough to know that people don't fake their fucking death if they have nothing to hide. Who the fuck do you think you're fooling?
I told you the map thing was a one-time screw-up.
What the actual fuck do you think you're doing? Harrison's been here one day and you have him in the woods looking for a man you killed? He'd be so much better off without you.
He's my son. I lost him once. I won't lose him again.
This is intense, man.
Once again, I have to stay a step ahead of everyone. With Matt's help, I can do that. Thanks, dude.
Like, this is what gives Dexter its, like, its charm as a show. There's, like, a constant level of just, like...
fear.
Yeah. Just pure
anxiety.
Panic.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's episode 2, and we're already feeling all of this.
More people to mess up the crime scene.
Hey, Jim. White buck. Left here to rot.
Such a waste.
None of us would have done something like this.
You think maybe Matt Caldwell would? He was hunting out here. It could explain why we can't find him.
This is bullshit, Angela. I'm betting the Caldwell kid did this, then panicked and ran.
There's no evidence tying Matt to this deer. So we'll process the scene, which you're all trampling right now, so please back up.
Shit. Why does my girlfriend have to be such a good cop?
For now, the search for Matt goes on, including here on Seneca land.
Pretty amazing how the entire town turns out for a Caldwell. When one of our girls goes missing, runaways always come back. After Iris, you of all people should know.
Things are different in Ireland now.
Sooner or later, you're gonna have to pick a side.
I mean, I would imagine they'd be able to match the bullet to the gun that he bought.
Harrison's great.
Right?
I just found this about a mile down the trail, right before I got to the
highway.
Thank you, Fred Jr., you magnificent outdoorsman.
Told ya. Chicken shit cutting ram.
Matt had gloves like that when he was in the store.
Indeed he did.
And there are smudges of blood on this. Let's get this and the deer back to town. We'll test the blood. We'll see if it matches. Thanks to you, we got some real leads. Not bad for your very first crime scene.
Lucky we stumbled on it. You can use my deer sled.
Why aren't you a cop anymore?
Oh my god.
Technically, I wasn't actually a cop.
Mom said you were a cop. You had to be better than these guys.
Maybe, but being at those crime scenes day after day just got to be too much. I'm happier now.
Selling night crawlers? Really?
So he pretty much knows everything, I feel like, at this point.
I mean, he knows something.
You're good with animals.
We had a goat back in Argentina. Sheep and chickens, too. What's the black one's name?
I've just been calling him Goat. Haven't gotten around to properly naming him, I guess. What was your goat's name?
Vincent. Vincent Van Goat.
I love it.
Meet Vincent Van Goat the second.
He likes that name.
If you want, you can just hang inside the cabin until I get back. I know how awkward it can be meeting new people. It was hard for me in high school, too.
Yeah, I survived the last 10 years without you, Jim. I think I can go 2 more hours.
Seems a little more outgoing than Dexter.
Yeah.
Well, he's not an awkward as fuck budding serial killer like you were.
Does that mean you're gonna start laughing at me again?
I don't know, you tell me. I know he shouldn't be around you.
Around this version of me. Jim Lindsay, he's safe.
You're starting to sound an awful lot like the old Dexter to me.
I'm not.
You are. You fucking love that you're getting away with murder. You can't wait to kill again. You are a fucking serial killer. You are gonna fail this boy 1,000 different ways because of
him. No!
Oh my god.
Whose face is that?
It's creepy as fuck.
Yeah.
It's like, can you not watch me while I sleep, please?
Super creepy.
Hey, it's not a big deal. My folks get queasy at the sight of blood.
Yeah, it gets to me every time.
Yeah.
Looks like the shooter didn't know what he was doing or was a pissed.
You feel the slug?
Yeah.
It looks like a hollow point 7 mag to me.
The bullets I sold Matt were 160 grain hollow point 7 millimeter Remington Magnums.
Lot thins. You and I, on the other hand, need to talk.
We need to talk. Words you never want to hear from your doctor or your girlfriend. Here it comes. The moment the girlfriend tells me I'm too closed off, that it's not going to work out.
I'm thrilled Harrison is here.
Then again?
You are?
Yeah. I know you've been private about your past. It's okay. Everyone has secrets.
Angie, I never meant for it to be a secret.
It's fine. We all have things we keep from each other, right? For instance, I'm not Audrey's birth mother.
Oh. You adopted her?
Yeah.
Did you ever look for the birth mom?
I've spent pretty much my entire adult life looking for missing women, but one who abandons her own baby? Fuck her. You could have shared your Harrison situation with me. This whole time I've been struggling with Audrey, thinking I couldn't share that part of my life with you. Now Harrison's here, and maybe that's an opportunity for us too. We can talk parenting, pressures, the worry, the guilt.
She flipped it on a positive.
I don't know that I can always be the father Harrison needs me to be.
I feel that way about being a mom every day. But it doesn't matter because Audrey needs me, just like Harrison needs you. All you really have to do is just show up.
You make it sound so easy.
Okay. Don't worry. Where the fuck is my phone?
Shut up.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what?
You're already dead?
Thank you. I hide the blood, I plant a glove, I match the bullet and the deer to Matt's gun, all to get the good people of Iron Lake off my land, and yet here I am, feeding them hamburgers. If I prayed, I'd pray for this to be over.
Everyone, we do not think Matt Caldwell is in these woods, so we are shutting down the search.
Prayer answered.
So the glove was a match.
Matt's friend confirmed it was his. And the smudges on it were deer blood. I'm guessing he's halfway to New York by now. The last thing this town needed was finding a body in the woods. So, we'll be out of your hair soon.
I came here for answers.
Ask me whatever you want.
Why did you leave us? Was it because of what you wrote in the letter?
What I wrote?
Reach out to me if Harrison shows any dark tendencies. Dark tendencies? What does that mean? What was so wrong with me that you not only left, but faked your own death to hide from me? What did you see in me?
Nothing bad. You were perfect. You were this sweet, smart, trusting little boy with a huge heart. It wasn't you I was scared of. It was me. I've always had my demons. I was scared that I'd mess you up, that I'd pass that on. So I went away. I was in a dark place after I lost your mom.
And then Aunt Deb.
And all that death. I got lost, and I thought you would thrive in Argentina. Walking away from you is the hardest thing I've ever done, and I regret it so much now because I never imagined you'd be left alone.
After Anna told me you were dead, I kept a photo of you by my bed. I would look at it every night. And for a long time, I cried myself to sleep. And then I found that letter. I was so angry.
Of course you were. But maybe I can be there for you now.
Do you really mean that?
If you're willing to risk the chance, then I'll screw you up.
Stop acting like you're such an evil person. I don't remember a lot, but all of my memories of you were good.
That's good.
The worst thing you ever did was...
Uh-oh.
Leave me. So yeah, I'll stay.
For a while.
You don't have to enjoy the wind so much, you smug fuck.
I love Bill. Is he getting, like, too comfortable? Uh-oh.
Is this the dad?
Did you find him? Tell me he's okay.
We found evidence that Matt may have committed a crime, killing an animal on reservation land.
No. He would have called me if he was in trouble.
He always does. An approaching fire isn't gonna scare him.
Wait a minute. I know that voice.
Matt killed a white buck on reservation land.
And I'm telling you that he would have called me. He's out there.
Detroit become human.
Matt's not perfect. He's made mistakes in life.
My son has disappeared and we need to find him now.
Yeah, the dad's gonna be a problem.
I need you to stand up for me, for my family. Same way we've stood up for you. Come on, half your kids grew up working at my truck stop. This is Iron Lake. We look out for each other. So please, I'm begging you, do not give up on my son now. Now when he needs us the most.
Everyone loves him.
Yeah.
Okay.
Too bad he raised such an asshole punk son. This is not good for Dexter.
It's not good.
Matt's out there. I'm going to find him. It's the last thing I do. The stone will go unturned.
Well, maybe some stones will go unturned.
Oh, shit! That's where... Oh!
Under the fire pit.
Oh, shit, dude!
That's good. That was good. I feel really bad for that deer.
Yeah. It's very sad. Dude, Dexter, that seems like a really dangerous place.
It's just right there.
What if they bring like a dog in or something and like...
Cadaver dog?
Oh my god.
That's terrifying.
I mean, Dexter's up to his old tricks and he's doing an amazing job, just like he always did with kind of putting the police department on a certain path that he wants. That he creates. But I feel like the dad now is going to kind of... like Dexter got everything that he needed. He got the gloves noticed. He saw that like he was able to match the bullets. And the fact that the road was really close. He was able to put all the pieces together for them to find out... oh yeah, Matt shot the deer and took off. It makes sense. And they kind of were like, we're good here. That's exactly what happened. Now we're on a manhunt to find where he went. But no, the dad shows up, and it makes sense for a kid like Matt, if you've got that relationship with your parents, with your dad, if you are in trouble, you call them. If you've got that relationship, you're going to call them. That's what I would do. If I did something stupid,
and I got in trouble... You are not some little fucking...
No, I'm not saying that I am, but I'm saying if I made an accident, if something happened, and I needed help... I would absolutely call my dad first. Like, Dad, I fucked up. I promise I didn't do it on purpose. But like...
Liar.
But that's exactly like the relationship it feels like. The dad does whatever he has to do for Matt. Gives him whatever he needs.
Enabler.
Yeah, 100%.
Privileged.
Right. And the fact that now he's got a really good relationship with everyone in this town. And he gave them like, support me now. Like, I've supported you. We gotta go find my son. And Dexter's like, fuck.
Yeah.
It's kind of the thing that I was expecting to play out. I didn't think the dad would be like an asshole with his kid and like shoo him away if he came up blessed. Like, oh, whatever, he's lost. He was a punk. Like, it didn't feel like one of those. And yeah, I think it's gonna be really interesting because Dexter's gonna have to continue to stay multiple steps ahead of the police department and the investigation. And we've got a helicopter. And what more are they going to bring into this, considering the relationship Matt's dad has with people? Like, are they going to pull in all resources? Like, this feels like it's going to be a really big thing, and Matt's body is just sitting in his little fire pit.
That, it's nuts. It's just nuts.
I for sure thought Dexter dumped the body somewhere, because he saw the picture with the hole, and he was like, it's not Miami Bay. So I guess maybe he didn't have time to get it out there.
Also, what happens when that water unfreezes?
Right.
You can't do that.
Yeah. Dexter's obviously out of the game a little bit, but he's still very smart and very capable of swerving the department and getting away with this. The Deb scenes, it's almost like... certain moments feel like a horror flick.
Yeah.
To where she's screaming at him and kind of coming out of nowhere and just the eeriness knowing that she's dead and like...
the tapping, the like shoving the bullet in his mouth. Yeah. Oh my god!
Like that was messed up. And her relationship with Dexter, it's really interesting right now because she's like antagonizing him. She had been supportive, like from the little bit that we had seen... she had been really supportive, keeping him on his routine, because his routine is everything, and now it's completely thrown out of whack. But yeah, now that he's killed, she's changed. And now she's just screaming at him, get Harrison out of here, you're just going to kill him.
What I noticed is, before he started killing again, she was wearing white.
Oh.
And now she's wearing dark clothes. Ooh. I don't know if that has anything to do with it. If Breaking Bad has taught me anything, is to notice their clothes.
Yeah. I mean, it would make sense, because now she's angry.
Yeah, she's pissed.
She's pissed.
Done fucked up.
This is good. I really like the first two episodes very much. It definitely feels very Dexter. You just feel like constant anxiety for him. Just every moment, just everything that's playing out. It's just one of those things where you've never rooted for a serial killer before. And it's like...
Not till now.
It's like Dexter. Dexter can completely change the game.
Yeah.
And it's just... It's interesting to see the side of him... See Harrison and everything that he knows. He kind of just keeps kind of revealing things as they have more conversations. I still think there's something there, for sure. I still think there's something dark. Do you buy 100% the cancer death for Hannah?
I'm not sure. It's plausible. I don't know.
If Harrison ends up being more than what he is kind of sharing, which would make sense.
His dark tendencies.
Yeah. I think lying about your mom's death obviously is a no-brainer. Mm-hmm. Or your stepmom's death. Mm-hmm. Hannah's death. I think that's a no-brainer.
I worry about revealing last names to anyone. Like, oh yeah, my mom, Rita Morgan. My name is Harrison Morgan, or maybe it's not now.
Yeah, I mean, it. There's...
How do you say that?
The cover-up is going to get tricky at some point.
Yeah,
The fact that Dexter is dating the chief of police in this town.
And there's a girl being held captive. There's so much stuff. I don't know.
I think that's going to be our big bad.
Yeah.
I think that's going to be our bad guy for this season. Because there's always one of them, killer, kidnapper, whatever this person is doing. I think this is going to ultimately be Dexter's nemesis. And the fact that there's so many of these girls missing, and now it feels like this person's got another girl trapped and spying on him. That note with the...
You're already dead.
That's horrifying. I couldn't imagine, but I think I would have noticed those cameras pretty quickly, to be honest.
I know, but she's in a nice warm place. Oh, champagne and strawberries right. For me.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting how they incorporate all this stuff and how Dexter interacts, or maybe he's already interacted. We've probably already met this character, whoever the kidnap killer is, and, you know, they'll probably reveal it at it. I think the easy throwaway person is the rich guy that everyone hates.
Yeah.
The politician dude. I think it'd be easy to label him as this is the guy who's doing this. I don't think it's going to be him.
No.
I don't know who it is.
No.
It would make kind of sense if it's like the goofy, I don't know what the hell I'm doing officer.
Yes. I also thought about that.
It's almost always someone that you wouldn't suspect. And it's like, oh, it can't be the goofy guy who's tripping all over himself, doesn't know what he's doing. It can't be him. I mean, yeah, we've seen that before. So I don't know. It feels like there's a list of people we could have seen this person. We could have not seen them yet. So we could possibly see. Since we're talking about kids, what if it's Trinity's kid? I don't think we ever got a...
Oh. You're a terrible person. Why would that come up all the way out?
I don't know. We're talking about here. We got Dexter's son. Might as well bring. I don't remember his name. Trinity's son that Dexter was super close with. I don't know.
Brad.
Just throwing all kinds of stuff out there. See what potentially stick. This is my favorite part of watching a show that's weekly. Is you could throw out a lot of stuff and not have to worry about it.
Yeah.
And I love making theories and taking guesses and trying to figure out the story before we get there. I think it's a lot of fun. But. And, of course, we have to wait and see how it all plays out. But
true.
I think through two episodes, I'm very much enjoying this.
Yes.
It feels so very good. Much like Dexter. It's got that anxiety. Like, they've been able to capture that anxiety and that stress pretty quickly, which was one of my concerns. It was like, how is the tone of this series going to feel? And it feels just like Dexter. It really does.
It does.
So
I was actually wondering, like, did they get, like, everybody that originally worked on Dexter to come back?
So I think the showrunner, I think the showrunner, you guys correct me, like, some people left comments about this, and I should have remembered it, but I think Michael C. Hall and the original show, like, the first four seasons.
Right.
The person who did the first four seasons
is doing this
with Michael C. Hall.
I love that.
Which makes sense, because that's, like, I feel like the first four seasons was peak Dexter.
Yeah.
That was in the argument for one of the best shows that we've seen.
Absolutely. I just...
It obviously kind of went sideways after that.
I love, you know, bringing people back together to work on stuff that they originally had worked together on. Yeah. And then it's... That just... I mean, even like a chaotic show, like a serial killer who gets mm-hmm. away with it.
Yeah, I mean, I would imagine that most people involved... Because I know how the fans feel, generally. I would imagine all the cast and everyone who put their blood, sweat, and tears and just their dedication to the show wasn't necessarily happy with how it ended or with the response of how it ended. So the fact that they get a kind of a second chance, you don't get this a lot in content like this. So, yeah, I'm very excited to see where they go. And if this is the way the story was kind of originally meant to end... Or if there was, like, alterations and edits done. The fun thing is we could look it up and check and see what people are saying about
without
it.
Without being spoiled.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, it definitely feels good. This feels like Dexter. And just, you know, the nerves are there. Yeah, so,
totally.
Any other thoughts?
No.
All right, y'all. You guys leave your comments down below, and we will catch you guys later for the next one. Have a good one. Bye.